Hi guys, this is Dr. Sadashivam once again with you. Today I'm going to give you a very, very happy news. India is the fifth largest FDI recipient in the whole world. Fifth largest FDI recipient in the whole world for this year. Mergers and acquisitions have played a very, very important role in making it possible. And what is extremely special is this is despite a 19% fall in investments in the greenfield projects due to the corona crisis. We have just been able to, you know, achieve $24 billion. In spite of this, we are the fifth largest recipient of FDI in the whole world. FDI stands for Foreign Direct Investments. It grossed 25% to $64 billion in 1 year. What makes it even more special is when the global investments shrank to $1 trillion, which means a 35% fall. The world, there has been a 35% fall in FDI investments in the globe, but India has risen by 25% to $64 billion in 1 year. This is as per the World Investment Report. Now we know that the second wave has hit us very, very hard, but certain things like your PLI schemes, PLI stands for Production Linked Incentive. We have talked a lot about it in the earlier videos, which talks about PLIs, where more than 2 lakh crores are going to be disbursed over the next 5 years to specific sectors to enhance India's competitiveness in production. When we say Make in India, it doesn't mean Make in India. It is Make in India, for India, for the world. We are not talking about self-sufficiency. We are talking about India being a supplier to the whole world. And especially these things coming, like China plus one. Many countries have lost trust with China, and people are looking at India as an alternative supplier. The winds are flowing. Now it's time we put those winds on ourselves and move towards the $5 trillion economy. That's what typically we are talking about. Now, if you look at the cross-border mergers and acquisitions, they have surged by 83% to $27 billion. These large inflows are mostly from this $1.8 investment from Amazon. There have been investments in Jio platforms, Brookfields, etc., etc. The investment of GIZ in the telecom towers, the Unilever merger with GSK, they've all attributed largely as far as these FDIs are concerned. Typically, when you look at investments, what does that mean? Investment is all about trust. To what extent people trust the Indian economy? There are lots and lots of people within the country who do not have any trust on the India and the Indian government. They will all find faults, whatever the government has done. They will all talk about demonetization, DSE, GST, how much it has affected the people in the country, how many people died on the queues to the ATM, etc., etc. But those things are past us. We are talking about the faith of the outside countries on India. The faith, because the strength of any economy is not decided on the basis of what some people in the opposition feel about the progress of the country, but in terms of how the other countries, other stakeholders, other markets. That speaks a lot about the strength of your economy, guys, because their stakes are involved. It takes a minute for anybody to take a new paper and start writing. It takes 5 minutes for any guy to put out a WhatsApp message and make it a viral message throughout the country, because stakes are not there. The guy is not putting one paisa from his pocket. But when these companies are investing billions of dollars into the country, that speaks volumes about what kind of trust they have on the economy of our country. That is a vote of faith, a vote of confidence, right? because any investment is about faith, trust, opportunities and return on investments. There are many, many companies throughout the world who are waiting for an opportunity to get in India. They want to shift their manufacturing operations to India because India is providing that kind of a climate to them. Ease of doing business. We have improved quite a lot on all those parameters. Even now people talk about GST and demon, which happened in 5 years back. Those stories are over. They are all long buried. It was like a hockey stick. Slightly it dips. It's like a hockey stick. It's a J curve. Slightly it goes down and then it starts going up. Now we are on the upper journey. Those things are long buried. We are moving towards a $5 trillion guys and the wind is there. We need to put that wind in the direction of our sail and we need to keep marching towards the $5 trillion economy. Let us all be optimistic and let's continue to create a new India, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video and this is Dr. Sadashivam signing off. Till we meet again. Bye-bye. Jai Hind.